Something draws us to the oceans of the Earth. We play at their edges, cross them for discovery and commerce, and harvest them for food.
This is really a water planet. Around 71% of the surface of the planet is covered by really an interconnected ocean. The Atlantic is connected to the Pacific, which is connected to the Indian Ocean, and so forth.
And yet we know more about the surface of the moon than the ocean's depths.
We've really only mapped about 20% of the ocean floor, even less of all of the waters of the deep.
Here, the greatest storms on Earth arise. Cyclones, typhoons, and catastrophic hurricanes.
Hurricanes feed off warm ocean water. Essentially, it takes that water, pulls it up into the storm, and then it's able to condense into the clouds, into the rain, and then also with that rising and sinking air, it's kind of causing a circular motion in the atmosphere because of the water that's pulled up, mixing with the winds aloft, helping to get all that going.
Dangerous as the oceans can be, take them away, and you're left with a big dead rock.
We couldn't have life without the oceans. The ocean is part of this intricate web that we have going, and without it, that would collapse.
Incredibly, most of our freshwater rivers and lakes wouldn't exist without the saltwater oceans. To unlock that seeming paradox, just look up.
The sun heats the ocean. The ocean heats up, and eventually that water evaporates, forms and condenses clouds.
Clouds generate rainfall across the world. That rainfall then helps to supply our rivers, lakes, and streams with the fresh water that we need. Eventually, all of that water actually ends back up in the oceans to start all over again.
Oceans do more than provide us with life-giving water. They help regulate the planet's temperature.
The ocean is really the engine that drives our weather patterns and our long-term climate.
Ocean water is coldest near the poles and warmest at the equator. But multiple currents, like the fast-moving Gulf Stream, push it around the Earth, redistributing heat and balancing temperatures.
Ask someone in England why their temperatures are a lot warmer than those on the same latitude out in Canada. One condition in Canada is snowy and cold, and England it's rainy and relatively mild. The reason why is heat transfer because of currents.
These currents are all part of a vast global system transporting water between the ocean basins.
Most people call this the global ocean conveyor belt.
Many forces move the conveyor belt: surface winds, the rotation of the Earth, and the gravitational effect of the moon all play a part. But like many recipes, the ocean conveyor belt depends on heat and salt.
It's thermohaline circulation, thermo because of heat, and haline because of salt.
Let's unlock how heat and salt move the oceans. As warm water moves away from the equator and cools, salt content increases through evaporation. This makes the water denser and heavier. In northern latitudes, the salt water mixes with fresher, less dense water and sinks. Then, deep ocean currents push that cold, salty water south to the equator, where it warms again and rises or upwells, continuing the ocean conveyor belt process in an endless loop that can take up to 1,000 years to complete.
And that's how the ocean currents redistribute the heat in the ocean.
Over the last few decades, however, studies suggest the global conveyor belt may be slowing down. The reason can be found up north, where the ice sheets are melting, mixing cold, fresh water into the salty ocean.
Those glaciers are inputs of fresh water into the ocean. So that will not only change the sea level of the ocean, that will change the chemistry of the ocean, and it could change the circulation patterns as well.
Too much fresh water dilutes the salt water, reducing the rate at which it sinks. The conveyor belt moving south slows down, and more than that, threatens to stop altogether.
So if all these currents stopped just dead in their tracks right now, it would be catastrophic for life as we know it.
Without the transfer of heat, Europe becomes 20 degrees colder. On the eastern seaboard of the US, water levels rise, swamping some cities. Towards the tropics, hotter water fuels more hurricanes. Life as we know it changes forever.